Why don't you give up? Aren't you afraid?
I have always kept my word, and I shall keep my promise. Betal, you are coming with me.
All right. Have it your way. But, and you know my condition, you will have to listen to my story during our journey and not utter a single word. Or I'll fly back to my abode. Once upon a time, a Brahmin, a learned one called Keshava, lived in the town of Dharmasthala. He had a small family, his son, wife, and his beautiful daughter, Madhumati.
Oh, Madhumati, my beloved daughter, how time flies. My little kid has grown up into a beautiful young woman. Time has come for me to find a suitable match for her.
Would you care for some more rice, father?
No, dear. Thank you. Listen, son, what is your name?
Greetings, I'm Vaman.
I would like to meet your parents, Madhav. Would you take me to them?
Hey, I have some good news.
Oh, what a coincidence! I have some good news for you too.
Well, then you go first.
I finalized a match for Madhumalti. His name is Vaman and he is very handsome. His parents are also very nice and very happy with the match.
What? You should have consulted me before finalizing it. I have also finalized the match for her.
Oh, father, mother, it's good that both of you are at home. I have found a suitable match for Madhumalti. His name is Madhusudan and he's a very accomplished man. What's the matter? Aren't you happy?
Alright, I've figured it out. Since it is Madhumalti whose life depends most on it, we will ask her to choose among the three boys. I will call all of them on an auspicious day.
I'm Madhu.
Please have a seat. Welcome to our home.
Get the doctor, fast!
It's too late. I'm sorry, she's no more.
The grieving grooms-to-be decide to collect the ashes of Madhumalti. Madhav performed the last rites.
Thank you.
All three of them collected the ashes and went in different directions to spend the rest of their lives searching for peace. Vaman went to live on the banks of the river Yamuna, Madho to some other town, and Madhusudan to live with a sorcerer and his family. One day,
Om Chamundai Namaha, Om Namaha, Om Chamundai Namaha, Om Kali Durga Namaha, Om Chamundai 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 Namaha,
I told you not to play here. Come inside. Don't disturb your papa. Come. Come inside.
What have you done? Shame on you. You are inhuman. You killed your own son in rage. I'm ashamed of living with you.
With special chants written in this book of black magic, one can turn ashes again into a living individual.
Madhusudan proposed the idea of bringing Madhumalti back to life to Vaman and Madhu, and they readily agreed. Three of them laid their claims on marriage to Madhumalti. Finally, Madhumalti was asked to take a decision. Now you tell me, Vikram, whom did she finally choose to wed? If you know the correct answer and are keeping mum, I shall break your neck. Answer my question now, or...
Oh, she married Vaman.
Are you sure?
Of course I am. It's obvious. Madhusudan gave her a new life, so he was like a father to her. Madhav performed her last rites, so he was like a son to her. It was only Vaman whom she could marry.
Bravo, Vikram! You are extremely intelligent. But why did you speak? You broke your silence. Bye-bye. Goodbye.
I shall not let you get away, you cunning spirit. Here I come, Bedal. You can run, but you can't hide. I shall get you.
Oh, that was such a nice story. Bedal told Vikram. What happened next, Vayu? Did Vikram take Bedal to the sage?
Yes, Vayu. Please tell us what happened next.
Yes, Vayu. Please tell us.
Okay, all right. Calm down. I shall tell you the rest tomorrow, but only if you promise to be good.
We promise.
All right then. We shall meet tomorrow to know the rest. Bye for now, kids. Have fun.
Thank you, Vayu. Bye-bye, Vayu.